In August this year, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, suspended the investigation into Dikton number plates by the Parliamentary Committee of Physical Infrastructure to allow the Minister of Security time to harmonize issues surrounding the controversial deal with MS Joint Stock Global Security Company. During today's Parliament session, the Deputy Speaker, Thomas Tayewa, summoned the Security Minister, Jim Muhwezi, to report back to Parliament with a report on how the government is going to go about this controversial deal of installing digital monitors on number plates. Tayewa also asked the Attorney General to explain the financing model of this project, which requires fines accrued from traffic offences to be committed to the MS Joint Stock Global Security Company, yet these funds were already committed to the road fund by law.
So colleagues, for example, on the issue of motor vehicle, we gave the minister 30 days, and I received that petition. In fact, there is a petition which came to the committee, and the petition had been given to around 10 agencies. The 30 days have elapsed, okay? So the Minister for Security should report back to the House on how he has handled the petition. Attorney General, on that same issue, there were issues which members raised on the legality, like money for fines, which money is already gazetted to be for road fund. Now, you sign with someone that he will take it away. Then you ask yourself, is a signature, a contractual signature, above the law? If it's not conforming with the law, how is it going to be implemented? Money for fines should be going to consolidated fund, and then it goes to the road fund.
Ronald Balimwezo, a member on the Fiscal Infrastructure Committee, says by the time the probe was halted, they had unearthed a lot of mess about this project, which had to be cured before the project implementation takes off.
There wasn't any single equipment in the centers. What we only found was a tent, an empty tent. And without any sophisticated equipment, not even a single equipment. And we are wondering, this is a project that should have begun. Then too, the contractor had promised to, by June 29th, to have produced at least 50 number plates, digitized number plates. We did not find any single number plate, not even a single one. Then too, they had to also show us the trackers. There wasn't any single tracker.
Legislators are also concerned with the cost of number plates, saying it's too exorbitant, especially for motorcycles, compared to the cost of motorcycles.
What we felt, of course, the cost, the haphazard way of doing work, in terms of, like, as if we don't have planners in this country, every other time something new comes up and it has a cost implication on it. As you're there, they tell you now we have these number plates later, they are changing, they are bringing new ones, here they are digital. We are not sure in the next 1 year what they are going to bring.
Whether actually finance was involved in the production of the financial model, which hiked the cost of a border border number plate, because a border border costs between 4.8 to 5 million. You cannot tell me that 20% is the cost of a number plate, 20% of the cost of the border border.
The cost of a new number plate was hiked from 150,000 shillings to 714,300 shillings. New vehicles and motorcycle owners will pay 714,000 shillings for digital number plates, while already registered road users will be required to pay 150,000 shillings for vehicles and 50,000 shillings for vehicles and motorcycles. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.